seventh grade, my friend Diane and I would walk to school. We'd pass the street that marked that side of town. The houses there were small, with rusty cars all up on blocks. And on the corner lived a girl named Tammy Brown. Tammy was 14, but she was still in seventh grade, since she missed more than half of every year. She was tough and she was tall, her eyes were green as Mountain Dew. And everyone said Tammy Brown was queer. Tammy wore boots, Tammy smoked cools. Tammy Brown. Fridays after school, I'd tell my friends, go on ahead. And I'd wait for Tammy behind Bob's barbecue. We'd walk home by the railroad tracks that led through the ravine. A shortcut only me and Tammy knew. Some days we'd pick up pig iron that had dropped between the ties and toss them one by one into the sky. Some days we'd line up some pennies on the humming rails and wait until a train came screaming by. Tammy wrote poems, Tammy drew horses, and I never told my other friends about Tammy Brown. Tammy said someday she'd like to hop a running train and ride it to the mountains or the sea. Tammy said she one day after science class, Diane took me aside and said she heard that I was friends with Tammy Brown. She said I'd better prove to her the rumor was untrue, or I'd never live that scandal down. So at lunch that day, Diane and several other girls led me to the bench where Tammy ate alone. I threw a bunch of pencil shavings in her chocolate milk, and I said, I hate you in a monotone. Tammy stood up, Tammy said, well, Tammy said, Diane and I could both go to hell. That's the last I ever saw of Tammy Brown. The people Tammy left behind grew up and moved away. Got engaged, had children and careers. but somehow I can't leave those tracks that lead through the ravine. I can still see Tammy's green eyes after all these years. Sometimes when it's quiet on a windy summer night, I'll hear a train come whistling. And though I know it's dumb, I think she's coming back for me. I'm sorry I deserted you. I miss you, Tammy Brown.